What we do know at this point is that there was a dark colored, possibly a black two or four door vehicle that pulled up next to the vehicle that Jose was riding in. There were some words that were said from that suspect vehicle, and then shots rang out from that vehicle. After those shots, that vehicle, being a two or four door dark colored vehicle, like I said, possibly black, then fled westbound through Decatur on Sahara and out of sight. This is a major intersection at Sahara and Decatur. There were many people traveling at 7:30 in the evening. We believe that somebody saw something. We believe that somebody knows something. This is a 17-year-old child, a child with a future that was in front of him, and he had done nothing wrong. He was the passenger of a vehicle. He was with family and friends. He had just left a local eatery, and unbeknownst to him, he became the victim of a heinous crime.
You see a group of individuals that's standing behind us. These are a few of our faith-based community leaders that come out when we have a horrific crime in this part of town, or any part of town. They're willing to help. They come out on their own free time to make sure that they assist the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department in gathering information. So
we do not believe at all that this is gang related. I can honestly say at this point, everything that we're seeing and everything the way that it appears at face value right now, this is a random act. And this is something that we can't tolerate within our community. Remember, this is a 17-year-old child. There were other children in the vehicle as well. This could be anybody's son, daughter, that could have been a victim to a crime. And unfortunately, this was Jose Pena that was a victim to a crime. We cannot forget, this is a child of our community, and we all need to be outraged. We owe this to Jose, who's 17 years old. We owe this to our community. We are looking for help.